I'm Kari Tammi. I'm an associate professor at Aalto University. I've been a professor for about 10 years. Earlier I worked for VTT, Technical Research Center of Finland. In my research focus, I've been studying electric vehicles, electric machines and energy efficiency for more than 10 years. In the time of Dieselgate, you might remember this scandal about vehicle emissions. I started to think why uncertainty is not taken into account in vehicle simulations and energy consumption estimations. We have only one truth when we run deterministic time domain simulations. I started to recall my early career at CERN in particle physics. Uncertainty is natural in research and probabilities are taken into account when analyzing the events. Why cannot we do the same in mechatronics? This is done in some areas of mechanical engineering, but not so much in mechatronics. So we developed uncertainty quantification methods and run Monte Carlo simulations on electric vehicles. And we applied our methods in a couple of research environments I saw later. I wanted to remind you that the data is everywhere nowadays. You have lots of data, but you have also lots of questions. How do you manage your data? What type of data you have? Can you rely on your data when your background assumptions change? How do you analyze it? So we have developed methods on these all. And now I saw first example, we run the uncertainty quantification methods on electric bus simulation models. The target is highly significant because electric vehicles are still expensive and you don't want to overinvest for your battery, for instance. Nor you want to exhaust your battery on the way. So you have to right-size your design. I saw some of our results here. These are the biggest influencers on the energy consumption in electric buses. Now the highest is stops per kilometer. Is it then a good idea not to stop at all? Well, no, it is not, because then you are not using your bus for to transport the people. So that we cannot really influence. But we can influence on driver aggressiveness, average speed, total stop time, and share of cruise time. And influencing on these, we can save energy, get a smoother ride, and have more sustainable electric transportation. We have used the digital twin to conceptualize our data management model. And we have applied it on the electric buses and in the research environment I will show you next. So overhead crane named Ilmatar is located in Aalto Industrial Internet Campus. And we have a physical crane there, plus we have digital twin on our hard drives. We have developed similar methods for crane operation as for the bus operation. And we have developed also methods for crane design to help designers to make more efficient, more sustainable, better products for the future. As a last thing, I would like to mention you that also user interfaces matter as we have lots of data nowadays. We cannot just swim in the data, but we need to enhance our user interfaces and not use only computer screens as user interfaces. For the purpose, we have developed augmented and virtual reality tools where you can add on the crane operator different features. You can maybe add some key performance indicators of the crane, maybe even entertainment. You can watch ice hockey results there, or you can plan your tasks in which order you do and what. Or you can maybe plan what tasks you can do before break. And speaking about break, I would like to thank you for watching this video and welcome you to visit our laboratories. We have 5 doctoral students, 4 postdocs, 4 master students, and few students from foreign universities visiting in our laboratory. So thank you again.